Hello and welcome. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how we can seamlessly publish Azure Databricks Unity Catalog backed tables directly to Power BI Online, eliminating the need for complex export-import workflows. I'll show you how we can configure the necessary permissions, set up Unity Catalog integration, and publish datasets with just a few clicks, saving you valuable time in your data analytics process. In order for you to be able to practice all of this, you need the following. One, a Databricks Unity Catalog backed data and cluster. Number two, you must have a premium Power BI license, which could be premium capacity, premium per user license, or fabric capacity. In this video, I'm going to be using the fabric capacity for demonstration. Number three, you must grant Databricks dataset publishing integration in the entry ID in the accounts to be used. And number four, you must enable read-write for XML endpoints in the Power BI capacity in the Fabric Admin Portal. Enough of talking, let's get started. Okay, so I've got three tabs opened in my browser. One is for the portal.azure.com and another is for the app.powerbi.com. And of course, I've got my Databricks workspace portal open. Now I'm going to start from here. We want to create a fabric capacity F64 which offer robust features and capabilities for data analytics workloads. So to do that, I'm going to look for this Microsoft Fabric. Now if you couldn't see this as part of the listed services, just come to this search menu and set for Microsoft Fabric and you're going to see it. Just click on it. So in this page, I'm going to click on create and I can see this create fabric capacity under the basics. We're going to choose the name of the subscription and the name of the resource group and then the capacity name. So for the resource group where this service is going to be housed, I'm going to choose my RCG Cornerstone Analytics and then I can scroll down. So I'm going to call this on my fabric and that's enough. You can use whatever name you like as the capacity name and I'm going to stick with the default UK style, which is the region that I'm presently located. And then we have this F64 as the size, the SKU. So I'm going to maintain this fabric capacity administrator and then click on the next. And I can see all of this detail. Click on the review plus create. And this is validated successfully. I can click on create at the bottom. All right, your deployment is completed. So I can click on go to resource and then we can see all the services in this resource. I can scroll a little bit and look for that fabric capacity, my fabric. So when I click on that, I can see the overview, which include the name, the status, location, and so on and so forth, and then the SKU. And I can always turn this off if it is not being used because we don't want to incur unnecessary costs. So you can just click on it to turn it off. You can click on it to turn it on. That's cool. Now, once we've created this, we can come to the app.powerbi.com and then we're going to create a file workspace and attach the newly created fabric capacity. So for that, I'm going to click on workspaces and click on new workspace. I'm going to call this on Databricks to Power BI. And once I'm done with the name, I'm going to click on this advanced option and then I'm going to scroll down to the very bottom. And then we have this fabric capacity and I can see we have the option to choose either a small semantic model storage format or a large semantic model storage format. And this is detected automatically. So I'm going to click on apply. So this is now applied, which is absolutely fantastic. Now we're going to proceed to the capacity settings of the Fabric Admin Portal. So to do that, I'm going to click on this gear settings at the top. And then at the bottom, I can click on Fabric Admin Portal under the governance and insights. So when I click on that, I can see the admin portal. Now I'm going to click on capacity settings. And then I can see we have the Power BI Premium Power BI Embedded Trial. Now I'm going to go to the fabric capacity and then we can see the name here, which is really cool. So I'm going to click on that to select. And as soon as that is selected, I can come to the Power BI workloads. So when I click on this, we have the option to enable the XMLA endpoint, which is the technical interface that allows external tools or platforms like Databricks to connect to Power BI. So I'm going to scroll down a little bit. And then we have so many options. Now I'm going to be covering all of this in future videos, but we want to focus on the extensible markup language endpoints. Now this is by default in a read only, but I'm going to choose the read write method and I can scroll a little bit and click on apply. Now this can take some few minutes in order for the changes to apply across board. So I'm going to come back to the portal.azure.com, and then in the search menu, I'm going to search for Entra ID. So click on that. Now in the Entra ID, I want to go to Enterprise Applications, which can be found on this left-hand side. Click on that. And then we have options for the Databricks data sets publishing integration. So I'm going to click on that to select. And once that is selected, this is going to load automatically, and then we can go to security and click on permissions. So when I click on the permissions, we have all the admin consent. So I want to pick the Power BI dataset.readwrite.all. So this is really necessary in order for us to be able to grant the permission to the Databricks data platform. So select this. Once this is selected, you can see this is now selected. I'm going to click on this grant admin consent for Cornerstone Analytics, which is the account in my portal.azure.com. So click on that. So I'm going to pick my account, which I've done, and then we have this permissions requested review for your organization. We have the Databricks dataset publishing integration. So all of this is fine. I'm going to click on accept. And once that is accepted, then we can carry on to the next stage in order to be able to perform the integration across the Databricks. So I'm going to come now to the Microsoft Azure Databricks. Now, we're going to create a table and load data from the file store to the table using a copy into command. Now, before we create the table, I'm going to come to my catalog, and then I want to go to the browse DBFS. In the file store, I've got this folder named sales, and in the sales, I've got sales 2015 to 2018.csv file, which are already loaded. Now I'm going to come to the SQL editor. In the SQL editor, I've got this create table, and the table is named sales underscore transaction with all of these columns that matches all the columns in the source data. Now, this specific catalog is created for this demonstration. I've got this Databricks to Power BI Online, which contains this sales underscore schema. And I can see at the top here, we have this Databricks to Power BI Online, which is the name of the catalog and then the name of the schema. So I can go on and create this table within that sales schema. So I'm going to say OK in a moment. So this has been created. Now I'm going to come down a little bit, and I've got this copy into sales table from this DBFS colon forward slash file store forward slash sales. So we are picking all the CSV files, and then the file format is CSV, and the format option is either equal to true, and we are inferring the schema. So all of these are set to true. Now I'm going to select this code to be able to copy the data into that sales underscore transactions. So click on this run selected. Okay, so we can see number of rows affected is 80. So we've got 80 rows of data ingested. Now I'm going to quickly just query the table just to see. So select star from sales underscore transactions, and then I can run the code. Okay, you can see we have all of this data. Now I'm going to go ahead and publish to the Power BI service. So how do we do that? I'm going to come back to the catalog, very important, and then I'm going to click on the name of the schema, and then I'm going to click on the name, the catalog rather, and then the name of the schema, and then I want to select the name of the table. So make sure this is selected, because if you select the schema, all the tables within the schema will be shared across. But if you want to share a specific table, just select the table, which I'm doing in this case. So this is fine. Now at the top here, we have this option to publish to Power BI Workspace, which is the same thing as Power BI Service. Now we have options such as open in Tableau Desktop, explore in Tableau Cloud, and then we can also explore in Power BI Desktop. But our focus is publish to Power BI Workspace, which is the same thing as Power BI Online or Service. So click on that, and then we have this quick find meaningful insight within you, blah, blah, blah. Now, we're going to choose our SQL warehouse serverless data warehouse. So I'm going to click on connect to Microsoft Entra ID. Click on that. And then we have the Power BI workspace that we can pick from. And then we have the Power BI semantic model and the Power BI query mode, either direct query or import. So now don't forget, the name of our workspace is Databricks to Power BI. So I'm going to come back here and set for Databricks to Power BI workspace name. And then because we are doing it for the first time, we can only publish new semantic model, but if we want to do it later, we can actually update an existing semantic model. But for now, we are publishing new semantic model. So this is fine. Now, for the Power BI query mode, we can use the preferred choice, which is the direct query. Now, this simply means that when we create any report in the Power BI service, the Power BI is going to send all the requests to the Databricks and then get all the solutions and bring it back to us. So we do not want to import any physical table. So we're just going to go with the direct query connectivity mode. And then for the table to publish, we can see Databricks to Power BI, which is the name of the catalog, and then we can see the name of the schema and the name of the table, sales underscore transactions. And then for the select table and set query modes, we have the authentication method in Power BI. Now we have two options, the OAuth or the personal access token. Now this is the recommended authentication method in Power BI. So I'm going to stick with that. And once that is selected, I can click on publish to Power BI at the bottom here. And then I'm going to just wait for some couple of moments and we should be able to see a successful publish at the bottom. And then we can go to the app.power BI to check it out. Amazing. So we can see successfully published data set, which is cool. And then we can see next step, you may need to configure OAuth credentials under data source credentials on the Power BI dataset settings. Now, this is not needed for us. So I can click on this open in Power BI. I can even come to this tab and then go back to the workspace we've created. Now we can see we don't have anything, no problems. Just click on this refresh. Ah, there we go. Even before clicking refresh, everything deploys automatically, which is absolutely fantastic. So we can see we have the name of the schema and then the name of the catalog and the name of the schema, which is absolutely cool. Now, don't forget, we are using direct query, not import mode. So when I click on this, I can see all the details, and I'm going to just wait for some couple of moments for the tables to deploy, that is the columns in the table to deploy, and there we go. Now, because this is direct query, we will not be able to see the contents of the other dates, region, and so on and so forth. But if you're using the import connectivity mode, we can see all the contents later. So this is working as expected, which is absolutely fantastic. Now, I'm going to click on explore this data. So I want to just create a simple automatic report. Click on that. And then we're going to wait for some couple of moments and see what happens. And this is our quick summary Power BI report in the Power BI service, which is absolutely fantastic. So we can see we have the sum of sales by region, we have the sum of sales by order date, we have the sum of sales by product, sum of sales by category. And at the top here, we've got this sum of sales, which is 328,481, which is absolutely cool. Now we're gonna come back to the Databricks and I can cancel this for now. That's sorted. Now I'm gonna go to the SQL editor, and in the SQL editor, I'm gonna get rid of this create table statement. I want to delete, and of course, I'm gonna delete all of this also. So I'm gonna actually automate by scheduling this job. So I'm gonna just leave this as this and click on the save functionality. So once that is saved, I can click on schedule. So I'm going to schedule this to run every minute just for demonstration, and I'm going to maintain all other settings. Click on create. Now, by the way, we're going to be using the serverless starter warehouse, so click on create. So we can see this has been scheduled. Now I'm going to go to the catalog, and then I want to go to the browse DBFS. Now I'm going to go to this sales folder. Now for now, we've got all of these four files. I'm going to load more files into this environment. Now, before I load more files, make sure you can see that we have 328,481 here. So I'm going to click on this upload functionality, and I want to bring in more data from 2019 to 2025. So this is selected, click on open, and I'm going to click on done. So we can see we've got all the data now ingested into the sales folder of the file store of the DBFS. Now I'm going to quickly come to the SQL editor, and I'm going to just wait to check the schedule out. I'm going to click on this, and let's just wait for this. So after this executes successfully, we should be able to see the additional number of data that has been ingested into the table. And then we can go to the Power BI service to check it out. So we can see this succeeded. Click on that to check it out. And Let's see, fetching data. Ah, there you go. Number of rows affected. So a total of 150 new data spanning 2019 to 2025 are now ingested into the table, which is fantastic. Now I'm going to come back here, and all I need to do is just to click on refresh. So now before I click on refresh, you can see the number is still 328,481. Now I'm going to see the refresh at the top right hand corner. Click on that and wait for some couple of moments. Amazing. You can see it is absolutely magical, and the number has grown to 106, that is 1,067,522. Absolutely cool. So everything is absolutely integrated and they are working, you know, seamlessly. So this is how we can publish tables from Databricks Unity Catalog to Power BI Online to create reports that update automatically when new data comes into the Power BI Unity Catalog. I trust you enjoyed the video. If you do, like, comment, share, and follow me for more videos, because there's a lot to come. Thank you for watching. Bye for now.